Hi students, I hope you're all doing fine. In the previous recorded sessions, we discussed about simpleton. You know, simpleton, the topic name itself suggests simpleton is nothing but the one who lives a very simple and a kind life. So, a king had two sons and the two sons had a cousin by name Simpleton. Once when they went out for a walk, they came across three things. One is the anthill, which the two brothers wanted to destroy. Secondly, they came across a pond where the ducks were swimming. They wanted to roast the duck, but Simpleton asked them not to do it so they stopped it. And finally, they came across a bee's nest, that is honeybees, which they wanted to light a fire under the tree so that they can taste the honey, but Simpleton stopped it, telling that you should not supposed to do it, and the brothers stopped it. And while they were going, they entered into a palace. From here, we had to continue the poem, I mean the lesson. Inside the castle, see, palace or castle where the kings and queens lived. The castle, they found an old man who was deaf. Inside the palace, there was a man who was deaf. The word deaf means inability to hear. Yani hum jo sun nahi sakte. Theek hai? Yani behra. When he saw them, he did not say a word, but led them to a table covered with good things to eat it. See, since morning, they were strolling here and there. They were wandering from one place to another place. And finally, when they reached castle, they were very hungry. They were starving. Like, since morning, they did not have anything. So, they were feeling very hungry. And the old man led them to the table. And the table was covered with eatables. Eatables means fruits, vegetables and everything. After they had eaten and drunk as much as they wished, he showed them beds where they could sleep. The old man showed them the table, he led them to the table, and once they finished eating how much they want, like till I feel complete, till that one they could have it, and till their stomach filled, they have it. And the old man again showed them the beds where they could sleep it. The next morning, the grey old man came to the eldest brother, made sign to him to follow, and led him to a stone table on which three sentences were written. See, if the boys were sleeping here, one table, two table, and three table. The three, here two, one, two, and three is simpleton. They were sleeping there, the old grey man, who led them to the table and who also showed them the beds where they could sleep it. Again, the same fellow, he came to the eldest brother and he took them to the stone table. He took him to stone table. Stone table means the table which is made of rocks, that is stone. And on that one, three sentences were written. How many sentences were written? Three sentences. So the first sentence said, in the wood under the moss are hidden 1,000 pearls lost by the king's daughter. Whoever can find them all in one day before the sun goes down will free the castle from its spell. But if he should search and not succeed before sunset, he will be turned into a stone. The first sentence was written on the stone table, that king's daughter, the castle in which they were sleeping, that castle is under the spell. Yani koi ek jadoo ke andar hai wo. Theek hai? Here, the stone table said so, that the king's daughter has lost thousands of pearls. Yani hazaron ki tadad mein heere ya moti. The king's daughter has lost it. Now, this fellow has to search the thousands of pearls before the sunset. He has the time only from sunrise to sunset. In this period of span or in this span of time, whoever will read that one, will read that sentence, has to search the thousands of pearls. If he fails to find the pearls, then he may be turned into a stone table. If I am reading a sentence on the stone table telling that king's daughter has lost thousands of pearls and I want to search it. If I don't search till the sun sets, then I may be turned into a stone. Isn't it? Is this clear? That's the first sentence. The eldest brother read these words and decided to try. So he decides to try that one and to find the pearls. He looked all day, but at sunset he had only found thousands of pearls and was there under turned into a stone. He could barely find only hundreds of pearls because he had to find more than 1,000. But he was able to find only 100 and he was failed, then he was turned into a stone. He was turned into a stone. In spite of this, the second brother made an attempt and began his task in the evening so that he looked all night. By sunset, next day, he found only 200 pearls and was turned into a stone. Again, the second brother also gave a try. The first brother gave only because he woke up in the morning and tried till evening. But this brother, thinking that he could not find it in the whole day, he started to search in the night itself. He did not sleep for that night and he started to search till the sun sets. He could only find 200 pearls. And again, even he was turned into a stone. At last, the simpleton had to look for the pearls, but he was very unhappy having to do it. He thought that he was so much more stupid than his brothers that if he had failed, of course, there would be no chance for him. See, because always these two fellows would say for simpleton, oh, you are very stupid and dumb creature. You don't have sense. You cannot live in this world and everything. Because they would always blame simpleton. He thought that it's of no use that I'm trying now. It's barely, I could even find it. So he became very, very unhappy and very sad, thinking that his two brothers did not succeed, then how I'll be able to succeed it. As he sat thinking about it, he saw coming towards him the ant king whose life and house he had saved. He had brought with him 5,000 of his ants, and it was not long before they had found all the pearls and piled them up in a large heap. Then they went home hardly waiting for his thanks. They had been glad to help him and thus show their gratitude. Here, Simpleton was brooding over all those things. Oh God, what to do? I could not find out. As he was sad thinking, the ant king, do you remember he saved the ant hill from ruining? In the last recorded session, I told how Simpleton saves the ant hill. As he was sitting there thinking what to do, an ant king comes towards Simpleton and he has bought 5,000 of his friends or his colleagues were with him, and they bought 5,000 of pearls. How much have they bought it? They bought 5,000 of pearls and they piled up in a large heap. Piled up in a large heap means they had to put it like this. Whenever you put chawal ya fir aap jabhi koi rice ya fir gehu aap dalte ho to ek gutte ki tarah ban jata hai waise. So this is nothing but pile of heap. Theek hai? This is nothing but pile of heap. Pile them in a large heap. Pile, matlab zyada dal dalna bilkul. Then they went home hardly late. They did not wait it. They just put the pearls, 5,000 of pearls here, and they just went away. When the simpleton went back to the castle with the pearls, he was given another task to do. The one task was to find the thousands of pearls, which he had found it. The next task was, it was to bring the key of the princess. Princess sleeping room from the bottom of the lake where it was sunk. Now, Simpleton had to find the key. Again, the princess has lost it where she was sleeping. The bedroom's key he has to find it. Which she lost it while in the lake it was sunk. Of course, he could not possibly hope to do it by himself. But when he went down to the lake, he found there the ducks. He had saved it from being killed. They knew him at once, and when they heard what he wanted, they quickly dived to the bottom of the lake and got the key for him. Do you remember the second task? The ducks, where again he saved it. when the gray man told that he had to find the key, he could not think that possibly, he thought it's impossible task to do. He again, in a positive hope only, he goes to the lake and he sees there that the ducks to whom he had saved, he told them that I want the key of the bedroom's key of the princess where she lost it in this lake. They goes, they dive into the lake and they bought the key. Now the third thing he had to do was the hardest of all. He had to go into the room where the king's three daughters were sleeping. King had three daughters. How many daughters? Three daughters. To find out who was the youngest and wake her up. The third task was very, very impossible because he had to wake up the youngest daughter of all. Because king had three daughters and three were sleeping next to each other. One daughter is sleeping here, another daughter is sleeping here, another daughter is sleeping next to it. He had to find who is the youngest one and to wake up. The only difference was that before going to sleep, the eldest had eaten barely the sugar, the second a little syrup, and the youngest one a spoonful of honey. The hint what the gray man gave was the elder daughter had eaten the sugar. The middle daughter, the second daughter, had eaten a syrup, and the third daughter had eaten the honey. Now they're all asleep. Only these are the hints that they have given. The eldest daughter had sugar, the middle daughter had syrup, and the youngest of all had honey. But how could he tell which had eaten the honey? Because just as he was wondering what he should do, it came the queen bee and seen the day before. All they were similar, see, all the daughters are looking alike. All them are sleeping to next to each other, and they're all looking alike. He was just confused. How do we have to find out that the youngest daughter had the honey? At the same time, the honey came, the queen bee. Here, do you remember here again, he saved the bees from lighting the fire? The same queen came and she sat quickly, flew on the lips, and there were flowers, and of course she knew the honey because she made it herself. Here, because the youngest daughter had honey, and you know honeybees extract the honey from the flowers, and because honeys are made by the honeybees themselves, the queen had known which daughter had had honey, so she thinks, she quickly flew to each of the sister and sat on their lips. So as soon as she sits on the lips of the youngest daughter, so he could tell which one had eaten the honey. She remained sitting on the mouth of the youngest. Then the boy knew who the youngest was. He woke her up, and the castle was free from its spell in a moment, and everyone who had turned into a stone was changed back into human beings again. There are many people, they came and they tried, but they could not found it. At last, only Simpleton had freed the castle from the spell of a magician. And everybody who had turned into a stone came back to life again as human beings. You may be sure the older brothers no longer thought their younger cousin was a simpleton. Now, the two brothers who always made fun of Simpleton was thought that he was not a simple but a very, very strong and an intelligent fellow. See, that's the thing I told you in the first class only, that nobody should judge a person by its outer cover. So, it's all about Simpleton. We always have to lead a very simple life. Simple living, high thinking. These are the things that we have to inculcate in our life also. We always must have to have a very generous heart, a generous attitude, a kind attitude, kindness towards others. We should always try to protect whatever it's possible from our side. Simply, unnecessarily, we should not destroy or ruin things, even if it is maybe living beings or non-living things. So if you have any doubt, you can feel free to contact me through WhatsApp. Till that one, stay home, stay blessed. Bye-bye.